Welcome back to the Hirschsprung Gymnasium here in beautiful Berea, Ohio, where the Brown and Gold Brigade just trying to get something cooking out here. Oh, you gods. It has not been that fun so far this season. What's not also fun is that not only is AJ Pistello sidelined, but so is our lead scorer, Ray Ellington, who's dropped 19.7 points per game this season. Our top two scorers are out for the year, or out for the time being, maybe out for the year. But it is rough to watch, and hopefully we can get something cooking, because it has just not been the most fun thing in the world, I will tell you that. We are a freshman-heavy team, but judging by the looks of this, he was also a freshman-heavy team, Ohio Northern. They only have one senior on the team. And what else? One, two, maybe two juniors, and everyone else is a sophomore and freshman, so there is that, and they're not doing shabby. They're 11-10 on the season. We're gonna need something, folks, because this has not been fun as of late. It's getting to the point where things are just looking rather ridiculous and rather frustrating. We're losing on average 10.1 points per game. We're scoring 71.2 points per game and giving up 81.3 points per game. What has Ohio Northern done? Might be wondering what Ohio Northern has done. They are 11-10 on the season and 6-8. I repeat, 6-8 in the OAC. I think they still have an outside shot at making the, what do you call it, the OAC tournament. We do not. Our season virtually all said and done by now, but doesn't hurt to win a game. Really doesn't hurt to win a game, and hopefully we will find a win soon. A lot of freshman talent, it's just that, once again, they're all freshmen. Makes it really hard to see the who's and the what's out there. Hopefully things will change soon for us. Well, good evening, everybody. I'm Tommy Maroon for WHBW. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon. I know next time we go live out here. Now, judging by the schedule, we have gone on a 6-game losing streak. Yikes, that is not good. Not good whatsoever. The only close game was to Muskingum and Capital in close games, where we lost to Muskingum by 9 and lost to Capital by 3. So there was that. But outside that, it's really been a blowout after blowout for this team. Well, I can only hope this is going to be a little bit different. If we can get within single digits, that won't be shabby. Coach Tom Howell's been left frustrated all season long, and he'd love nothing else but a win. Our starting lineup looks a little different, but first, before we get to our starting lineup, we got to the Northern starting lineup. It looks a little like this. Will Miller, Blake Michael, Carter Reese, Jadee Cunningham Jr., and Caden Jacoby. And for us, it looks a little different, as I mentioned earlier. It consists of Miles Reynolds, who's different, Tyus Baskerville IV, who's the same, and Luke Driscoll, also different out there. Andrew Griffith, also a little different, and Rob Watson III. Rob has only started 6 games. Luke has started 5 games. Only 4 starts for Miles this season. Otherwise, just looking at Titus, he's started all the games this season. He's the only man on this team that has started this season. And Andrew has only started 4 games this season as well. You see Andrew to the right of your screen, number 21, for the Brown and Gold Brigade. Of course, the women's team, has a tough opponent as well in the Ohio Northern University Polar Bears. That's going to be fun to watch. Of course, we won't be there, obviously. So there is that. So you never know what can happen. have about 10 minutes to go till it's rock and roll time on this beautiful YouTube channel. I see some fans are here as Titus, the left-hander, practicing his free throws, and he got it. The gang hits the locker room, where Coach Tom must be, I assume. As you see, high fives being given out. Brian Schmidt, Coach Tom Howell's assistant. Tom Harrington, Jamil Cosby, and Will Ciccoli are the assistants. Nate Hart, Athena Sebastos, and Eric Wilson. Our student assistant coaches, as is Kevin Walker. We possibly forget Kevin, who takes photos for the team. For Ohio Northern, their head coach is Neil Young, not to be confused with that old singer Neil Young. And he's assisted by John Trope, Guy Neal, and Isaiah Boxall. Just judging by everything, they have one sophomore starting, one junior starting, everybody else a freshman, which is kind of hard to believe. They're getting stuff cooking with the freshmen. We are not. But that is just for this season. Hopefully times are going to be changing soon. Hopefully we handle our Northern loss out here, because things have been looking rather frustrating for Coach Tom. He's gotten really nervous, I can only assume. But looking, Reese, Miller, and Cunningham Jr. have more than 10 points per game, and they have been starting a lot. In fact, Blake Michael and Will Miller are the only two guys that have been starting all season for them. Of course, they've also been rolling with guys like Carson Connolly and Theo Magg, not to mention Mason Studer, and who else? Let's look. Noah Langford, I already mentioned. Hayden Hansen and Carson Connolly. But yeah, you got the gist. What has Ohio Northern done as of late? Well, they knocked off Heidelberg. They knocked off Marietta after losing four straight games. In fact, they were on a six-game winning streak at one point. My goodness. They beat Ursinus, Olivet, Otterbein, Muskingum in overtime. They beat us by 22 earlier this season. And then beat Capital by 7. Then suffered a four-game losing streak in the hands of Wilmington Carroll, who's now number 2 in the country right now. No, I think John Carroll's number 1 in the country, actually, once again. Hard to believe. I know John Carroll on top of the D3 world right now. They have what it takes to perhaps win the national championship. Well, it wasn't my train of thought. Lost to Otterbein and then lost to Mount. But they've gone back to their winning ways with a win against Heidelberg and a win against Marietta. The women's basketball game will be fun to watch, or at least fun to keep track of if you're going to be watching this broadcast tonight. I hope you do. Have about 6.5 minutes to go. Student section not even bothering showing up tonight, which is quite a shame. Only say it. Let me say it again. I don't care what your thoughts are on the team. I'd still show up to the games. In fact, I always show up to the games. We have about 6 minutes to go till it's tip-off time. As we're waiting for the good guys to break out. So we'll see what happens. Hopefully we can win this game. Once again, things have been really rough for us over basically the entire season. We're on a 6-game losing streak. We've lost 10 out of the last 11. So there is that, and 11 out of the last 13, and 15 out of the last, 16 out of the last 20. It's been rather rough. And we only have 3 home wins, no road conference wins at all this season, which is bound to drive Mr. Howell nuts on behalf of Coach Schmidt and Mr. Harrington, Mr. Cosby, and Mr. Cicoli. I'm pretty sure you would all know that by now. The Polar Bears are back out as we're trying to get something brewing out here, trying to get something cooking. Here come the good guys. Will we win the game is the question. Good times have been hard to come by for the Brown and Gold Brigade this season in men's basketball. But hopefully this is going to be a little bit different. As you see the team break out. Hi. Well, how are you today? As you see the gang practice their shots. Go, nice throwdown right there by Caden. Caden hasn't played that much. He's played a lot of games, actually. That's more than half the games this season, but hasn't had that much action. 1.2 points per game. Titus is averaging 8.2 points per game. Our best three shooters, Miles Reynolds at 37.5. And of course, Brandon not so far behind him, 24 for 71. All his field goals except 5 have been 3s for us. And of course, Ray 42 for 126 out of the season. Please, dear Lord, let us win.
Be proud, be
positive, well
and be positive. Thank you.
That is the intent. Of course, the gang doesn't go out there every night and think to themselves, how can we lose the game? We go out there every night and think to ourselves, how can we pull off an upset? How can we do this? How can we win the game? You know, this team cares deeply. Shots will hopefully be flying in tonight. I mean, they've been a little bit rough for us this season. We're shooting 42.6%. Ohio Northern shooting 46%. We're giving up 47% for the shots that go in, and we are shooting really rough 30.9% from the three-point land. And of course, the Bears are shooting 33.7 from three-point land, which is a little more than one-third. Less than 2 minutes to go. I'm a little nervous, folks. I don't know if I'm the only one that's nervous. But I can only assume you are as well, folks. We're shuffling our feet. Trying to pick up a win. That would be nice. That would be super nice. When I say super nice, I mean 100% nice. Will we do it is the question. We will find out in about 90 seconds from now, plus the national anthem and, of course, all that fun stuff. See the good guys practice out there. We'll see what happens. We'll send it down to Dave Cameron, the public address announcer, who always has us covered. Of course, Braden Hamilton, by the way, is back. That's good. Always good to see number 4 Braden right there back in the action. He was sidelined for a little bit as the good guys would be lining up for the national anthem and all that fun stuff. The BW Pep Band gun performance, as they always do. We'll be ready in just a jiffy, ladies and gentlemen. So let's get right into it.
University Polar Bears and your Bulls University! 12 record in the OAC. At this time, we ask that all fans please rise and kindly remove your caps as we honor America and those who protect our freedom at home and abroad with the playing of our national anthem, performed tonight by the BW Pep Band.
Jacoby stands at 6'8" during the tip-off against Rob Watson III, a 6'6" senior. Jacoby 6'8" freshman can't teach high. Here we go, Yellow Jackets Polar Bears opening tip-off won by the Bears. Great have a good time with a good play by playing. Now passing underneath the bucket, the 2-pointer no good. Second chance shot is good. Music is still rolling. That's certainly odd. We're already down. Miles passes that to Rob. Rob going to pass that to Andrew. Andrew's got Titus wide alone, but he undershot him. Intercepted by number 21, Jody Cunningham Jr. Miller going in. Miller spinning. Miller for two. He misses. Luke tries to bully away from everybody, and he does. Luke passes that to Miles. Miles going in. Miles going to pass it. Shot down by the Bears. Still our ball, 42 seconds through the quarter and half. really the half, I should say. There are no quarters in basketball, in men's basketball at least. Never understood why. Bob's gonna pass that to Titus off screen on the right side. Titus gonna step back. Titus showing off some moves, gonna pass it to Miles. Miles in trouble. Miles gonna lob that one to Rob. He's got a little quiet underneath the bucket. Now Titus passed to the fourth. Is gonna make the three. All right, that's more like it. Cunningham with it. Cunningham goes behind the back. So we're winning today. Because we won't be trying for the whole game. Cunningham going in, he got it. 4-3. Here is Luke. Luke gonna pass that to Rob. Rob is gonna have a reach and foul committed against him. Jody Cunningham Jr., 6-foot freshman from Westerville South. Did the foul. Here we go, handing off to Luke. Luke gonna step back. Luke passing it to Andrew. He's gonna load up far away for three and he misses. Rebounded by the Bears. Passing on the right side, number 15, that's Carter Reese, and now number 21 is Cunningham. Cunningham passes that to the left side. Here they go with number 2, Will Miller. Will Miller driving in. Miller gonna have that thing rejected, but they get it back and passing underneath the bucket for 2 points. Good by Caden Jacoby. 6-3 on you. Andrew, and now Titus passing that to Rob. Does he dare take a three? He's been struggling from 3-point land all season as he passes it to Miles on the left corner. Gonna pass that to Luke wide alone. Luke thought about the three. He's gonna pass it. Here comes the three on the way. Miles Reynolds got it. All right. It was a deep two, actually. I stand corrected. We're still losing. But it's only a 1-point game for now. 2.5 minutes through the first half. Looking right here. Gonna pass underneath the bucket. The 2-pointer's blown by Blake Michael. Man, oh man, I did not anticipate that. Here we go. There's a foul called. Miles may be going to the line. We're gonna huddle up. Number 2, Will Miller, committed the foul.
Will Miller is first team second.
Question is it a shooting foul? By the looks of it, it is not a shooting foul. High lob, Rob's got it, passing it right side, that's Miles. Miles Reynolds stepping back. Miles looking, Miles gonna go right, good screen by Andrew. Andrew loads up, a deep three coming up is no good. Good rebound by Rob, and he is fouled. All right, that's more like it. It will go to the line, 2 minutes, 57 seconds through this. Alrighty, the Bears in trouble. Blake Michael commands the foul.
To the line, shooting two, number 32.
Rob having a rough time at free throw land. He's 11 for 26. And the rough times may be continuing. He misses the first. He can at least tie it. Rough times continue. He's 11 for 28 from the line this season. Cunningham has it. Cunningham passes that left side. That is Caden Jacoby. No substitutions coming up yet, as here is Jody Cunningham passing on the left side, driving in, looking, gonna pass it. It's gonna be taken away by the good guys. Tice gunning that one to Luke for two. It is good. 7-6. As here's Cunningham Jr. with it. Cunningham going to the right side with a bad pass, Alvear ball. 3 minutes, 34 seconds through this first half. It is 7-6, Brown and Gold Brigade on top for now. Titus has it. Titus going left. Titus with a nice pass out to Miles. Nice pump fake, Miles Reynolds, he misses. Rebound by 21 Cunningham. He's going to escape and pass it to Carter Reese. Carter Reese right side. Here comes the three on the way. It's no good. Good rebound there. Spinning, passing back out to Miller. Will Miller right side. Stopping, popping, shooting. Missing right there was number 21 Cunningham. Passing that to Andrew. Andrew out to Rob. Rob hasn't attempted a three, by the way, this season, so I stand corrected. It's almost shot down, but Miles retains it, and it will be shot down now. Going in, the two-pointer is good. Will Miller scores it. Looks like we'll have Leon Levski in on the next dead ball, as we will have Braden Hamilton as well. Right side, driving in, spinning. Here's a three from Andrew, struggling today from the three-point line, and the struggles continue. Stopping, nice move there by Cunningham, lobbing it deep to Jacoby. Jacoby going in, Jacoby with a nice move to the bucket. He's not fouled, never mind, he is fouled. And now we're down 10-7. Rob commits the first foul of the game for us. Leon and Braden checking in for the good guys. Mason Studer, Noah Langford in for ONU. We have played a quarter of this half and 1/8 of this full game. Here comes the second or first shot by Jacoby. It's good. And the only shot by Jacoby. Here they go on defense. Here we go on offense. Miles passing that to Braden. Braden, not a bad three shooter. He's going to pass that to Miles. Miles looking. Miles left side. There's Leon. Leon passes that. Braden, speaking of which, he's going to take a three, and he got it. 11-10 is our score now. Told you he's not a bad three shooter. In fact, he's a good one. Looking right here now, it's number one, Studer. Studer passes that, and there's going to be a foul called on Braden. He can't believe it.
Foul the Yellow Jackets, number four, Braden Hamilton, his first, team second.
From 15, Carter Reese inbound. No, number one, Mason Studer inbounding. Reese was just in the corner. Right side to Studer. Studer passes that, going in here. Jacoby, the two-pointer is good. 12-1. Here we go. Luke running left. Luke gonna pass that to Braden. Not gonna take the three. Shy's gonna pass it. It's tipped right to Miles for three. We are tied. Good shot by Miles Reynolds. And it's 13 apiece. Still early in this game, but you never know. Offside, it's Langford passing it back. Here comes the three on the way. They will respond with a missed three. But a foul called on the good guys. Who was it, you might be wondering? It looked to be Andrew. It's Jared Logan checking in for Andrew. Each school with three fouls so far. Will Miller back in for ONU. But Theo Mag, a 6'7 freshman, is in. Forgot to mention that Caden is in. No sign of Titus right. Never mind, he's right there actually. Actually, never mind, he isn't there. I apologize. Driving in, looking, 10 to shoot, spinning, gonna pass it, and Caden's gonna poke it away. Jared off and running. Jared for two, it's good. 15-13. Studer trying to tie this game up again. Studer right side. Passing it to number five, Connolly, and now a three coming up. They don't want to tie. It's an air ball, and oh, it goes right off Landon Potofsky. Oh, that is rough. That is super rough. ONU ball still. Connolly. Carson Connolly, the only senior on the team, passing it around to the right side. Four to shoot, going in, spinning, the two-pointer, no good. Rebound on the good guys. Braden with it. Braden with 1-3 tonight. We have not been doing a shabby job shooting three so far tonight. Here's Jared. Jared gunning that to Landon. He wants to know he's going to go in instead, and he got it. And we're up by two scores now. Good job by Landon making it 17-13. Left side, here we go on defense. 33 is Mag. Theo Mag gonna try to drive in. Brayden playing tight defense as Conley passes that out to Langford. Langford spinning. Langford forgot something. Gonna be taken away by Leon. Leon in trouble. Leon passes that to Brayden. Deep three coming up. It is off target. And it will be polar bear ball. 12:08 to go in the first half. Timeout taken as Jody Cunningham Jr. will be checking in for ONU.
Timeout.
17-13, you see the score right there. 7 minutes 52 seconds elapsed in this ball game.
We're just trying to get something cooking, folks.
By something, I hopefully mean something. ONU took the timeout. Here the fight's on. All right, we're ready to rock and roll once again. 21 is Cunningham Jr. Jody Cunningham Jr. pass midcourt, flips it back. Flipping it around still, that's Studer. Studer out to Cunningham. Cunningham feeling the heat of the double team. He's gonna escape, he's passing that to Studer. Studer with a nice pass right there. Number two, Miller. Will Miller gives it off to Carson Conley, and a nice move right there. Cunningham is good.
Jody Cunningham Jr.
Here we go, the other way. It looks to be Landon, no, Caden, I beg your pardon. Caden out to Jared. Jared looking, Jared driving in. Jared gonna pass out, shot, here we go. Offside, Caden for three, guys. Maybe blocked, as Conley thought was blocked. Passing it on the left side, driving in. Gonna pass it back wide alone for three, and thank God it's a miss. Landon on it. Landon gonna go off. Landon stepping back. Landon Potopski trying to get past Cunningham, and now he's being guarded by Mag. Here is Caden going in. Caden lost the ball. It'll be ONU ball.
You dig in for the Polar Bears, number 15, Carter Reese.
9 minutes, 5 seconds elapsed in the first half, where the good guys are ahead for now, 17-15. Win over the Bears would be nice. Number two is Will Miller. Left side they go. Coach Schmid standing up. Looking right here, passing it to the right side. That's 15, Carter Reese. Now here they go, offside, stopping is 21. That's Cunningham, and now number five, Connolly. High wall, Brayden shot it down. Thing is, he shot it down out of bounds. 8 to shoot for ONU as Blake Michael back in for the Bears. Got a lot of friends at ONU, I'll say that. Tipped like a volleyball, I guess. Miller passes that to Cunningham. 3 to shoot, 2 to shoot, 1 to shoot. Shot clock violation. That will not count. Bucket
shot
wasn't going
clock violation.
All right, 10:23 to go in the first half. Still 17-15. Caden spinning. Caden passes that to Landon. Landon going right. Landon in trouble. Landon going in. Nice shot, but he's fouled. Almost halfway through the first half. Landon Potopski going to the line. Right. 9-27 from the free throw line. Things could be going much better for Mr. Potopski, the sophomore from Strasburg High School in Dover, Ohio. There we go, there's one that goes in. He's 10-28.
for the Blue Bears, number 34.
We're only shooting 59% the free throw line. That is not good whatsoever. But it'll go up a little bit after that. Lucas go back in for the good guys. Cunningham Jr. has it. Cunningham looking. Gonna bounce it right side. Number two, Miller. Miller passes it. Quite a shoot. Gonna go towards the right side. As a three from the left hander is no good. And a foul on ONU. Reese attempted a three, by the way. Blake Michael did the fouling. 9:47 left in the first half. We can get some separation perhaps out here. Luke in trouble. He got sprayed in, and now back to Luke. Luke out to Jared. Jared driving in. Jared for two. He misses. Nice rebound, but he's stripped of the ball. No foul call. 21 is Cunningham. Cunningham with a nice dish to the left side. The three-pointer, he's fouled too. Will Miller got fouled by, looks like either Leon, yep, Leon. Andrew and Robert in for Jared and Leon. Leon on 6-1, Jared 6-5. This ballgame will not be tied. In fact, they'll just take the lead. Blake Michael on the rebound. Good lord. 20-19 is Rob passes out now to Braden. Braden looking. Braden out to Andrew. Andrew gonna pass that right side. Here we go. Driving in. The pass in the corner. Three coming up for Braden. Boom! Shakalaka. 23-20. Braden has done it again. Here is Jody Cunningham Jr. with the ball going left, flipping it out. And now that's Miller. Miller to the right side where Jacoby is going to try to put up this shot and he misses. Ooh, two men try to get for us, but Braden winds up with it. Going in, stopping, popping, shooting, missing. Tipped, rebounded by ONU. 15 is Carter Reese. Carter Reese across midcourt. He's going to pass that to 21 Cunningham. Cunningham with 8:15 in the first half. Cunningham driving in. Cunningham almost forgot something. Cunningham, he is gonna be fouled by Rob. He can't believe it. 8 minutes, 9 seconds left. That means five fouls for both schools in this half. Miles and Titus. We're back in. You know, for a team without our starting star two scorers, we are not going to stab the job as Carter Reese misses. We're going to pass that to Braden. Braden going to pass it back. That's Andrew. Now here we go, right side. Driving in, passing it to Luke Driscoll. Luke going to go in. Luke floats that one up, and he floats it in. 24-20. All right, there we go on a 5-0 run. Right side of Carter Reese. Reese passes that to number three, Langford. No, Langford going right. He's going to pass it again. Good pump fake there by Reese, but he's got a tough test shooting it over Andrew. Less than 10 to shoot. No, Langford, tough too. I didn't think so. Braden grabs it. Here comes Titus on the right side. Titus. Back out to Braden. Braden's gonna take a three, why not, but he missed. Good rebound there by Blake Michael. Passing it to the right side where Mason Studer waits. And now here they go, nice behind the back dribble going in, gonna pass that one. Tough two is good off the glass by Caden Jacoby. Andrew has it. Andrew going right, passing it's tipped and out of bounds on Ohio Northern, right. Jared in for Braden. Braden definitely deserves a break. He's had himself a fine one so far. Jared in his spot. Here we go, driving in. Titus passes that back out to Luke. Luke passing it to Jared, 11 to shoot. Jared gonna pass that right side. Titus loads up, fires away around the rim and in. All right. Everybody getting a kick out of that. 27 to 22. Left side they go. Now here they go, Reese. Reese passes that out to number 5, Carson Conley now underneath the bucket. That's Langford now driving in, stopping, spinning out to Langford. Langford 6 minutes to go. Langford is fouled. He will not get the bucket to go, despite it going in. Foul occurred before the bucket, and it looked like 21 on here again. Leon checking in for what looks to be Andrew. Andrew was struggling with fouls, I guess, too, so far. It's not even halftime. And Jacoby got it. 27-24. Here's Miles on the left side. Miles passes that to Jared, not taking the three. Jared in trouble. Jared's fouled. Looked like he was fouled by Jacoby. Was fouled by Jacoby. One more foul by either school, and the other school will be in the bonus. Theo Mag in for the ONU Polar Bears. Good catch there by Jared, who hands it off to Titus. Titus gonna try to drive in. No, nice pass, Jared. He's gonna go in. Jared steps back. He takes a deep two. That thing is gone. 29-24. We're up by 5 now. 5.5 minutes to go. Watch out. It's Studer. Studer passing that around. Here they go out to the right side. That looks to be Mag. Theo Mag passes it back now. Here they go on the left side. 5:14 left. Number 3 is Langford. Langford for 2. He got it. 29-26. A little over 5 minutes to go here in the first half. Luke Driscoll going in. Luke passes that to Jared. Jared's going to take the three, and he misses the three. Rebounded by Studer. Studer across midcourt. Studer still holding on to it. Mason Studer spins, turns around, misses. Jared gets it from everybody, passing it to Miles on the left side. Miles going to try to go in. Miles lost the ball. Jody Cunningham Jr. back in for those ONU Polar Bears. Number 21 is Cunningham. Now they're just tossing it around. Will Miller down left side. Three ties it. I don't think they're going to go for a three just as that shot's rejected by Jared. It is Miles with the ball. Miles looking, Miles in trouble, right side we go, Titus left wide alone, he's going to get it, he's not going to take the three, he's going to step back now. Titus looking, he pump fakes, pass that one to Jared, out to Titus left side, Titus going in, Titus, oh, he slipped. Here comes Ohio Northern, the two-pointer is good. Cunningham scores as we burn a timeout with 3:55 in the first half.
Yellow Jackets, 30-second timeout.
30-second timeout. WHBW, your one-stop for all things Highland Ball and Roller. We're trying to get something cooking out here. We have to get something cooking without those two guys in the back. Agent Stowo with the great jacket and Ray Ellington with the L line. That one. by one right now. What happened? Oh, now ready to break out again. Lead school with 5 timeouts left. We'll see what happens. Titus Gatsek. Titus passing that to Jared. Jared gonna go out to Miles. Miles looking. Miles spinning, passing to Jared. Jared in trouble. Jared with a nice shifty move, going in for 2. Nice shot, Jared. They need to get the ball, because they aren't right now. Right side, it's Will Miller. Will Miller passes it back. Cunningham Jr. gets it back from Mag. And the high pass out to Theo. Mag is going to swat it right to Iowa Northern. Coach Tom not happy about that. Here they go upside. Good pump fake passing it. Carter Reese taking a 3, and we are tied. We've come back from 5 down. Notting it up at 31. Titus out to Jared. Jared passes out in the corner. Good move by. Ooh, a foul. Nope, but Titus got it instead. Miles, I beg your pardon, not Titus. 33-31. Here's number 5, Conley. Conley running left. Conley running right. Conley spinning around, passing it. We are on defense right now, as you can tell. Will Miller stepping back, passing it to the left side. There's 7 to shoot, passing it to Miller. Miller for 2, and we are tied once more. Titus. Titus handing it off to Luke. Luke Driscoll. Out to Jared Logan. Jared with the ball. Jared, he's got a man, and that's Miles. And now Titus going to take another 3. It is no good. 2 minutes to go in the first half. Trying to drive in the 2-pointer. Does not have enough monster. Ooh, that almost went in on ourselves, but the 2-pointer goes in regardless. And yet another timeout by the good guys. Coach Tom's got to be a little nervous now. He's lost the lead. After we've been winning for a vast majority of this first half, it is now 35-33. And this is a team that has swept his by struggling in the second half. Seconds to go in the first half. The horn sound. We're trying to make sure we can time that. I know what the score of the women's game is. Hopefully it's going better than this. And this game isn't going bad, of course. We're only down 2. But the women's team just trying to stay up top the OAC. That's never an easy thing to do. Titus. Titus driving in. Titus, oh, a nice pass out to Braden. Braden, it's almost stolen. It's outbounds on the good guys. No, it's outbounds on the Bears. All right. 13 to shoot, 93 seconds left in the first half. Titus, less than 90. He has less than 10 to shoot. Titus going in, passing that out to Braden. Braden, why not? Oh, nice pump fake, and he missed the 3. But we got it back. All right, Titus with it. Titus looking towards his left. Braden setting up the screen. Here we go. 3 coming off. That thing is good by Leon Levesque, the left-hander. 36-35. We have 1 minute in the first half. Here's 34, Kane Jacoby on the right side. Passing that towards the middle, now out to 21. Cunningham, and now on the right side, that is Jacoby, and now wide open for three. That thing is good by Carter Reese.
Carter Reese,
38-36. About 6 seconds in between the shot clock and game clock. Titus passes that to Braden. Braden passes it back out to Leon. Leon not taking the three. Leon is somehow not fouled. They can hold it for the last shot they want, but they're just going to take the two right now.
Will Miller.
Will Miller scores it. It's a four-point contest. Obviously, we got to hold it for the last shot. It'll be bare ball to start off the second half, as you can tell right there. And it looks like Miles will be going to the line. For a team that's been struggling immensely from the charity stripe this season, this one not, or Miles has not been shabby. 30 for 35 as Luke going to the line. 6.1 left in the first half, 40-36 ONU. Miles makes the first end of the 1-1. Jared gonna check in for Braden. Braden having himself a dandy so far. He's drawn a lot of threes, that's for sure.
Into the game for your Yellow Jackets, number 24, Jared Logan.
And the second shot by Miles also good. So he's got it to at least a 2-point game at the half. Caden back in for the Brown and Gold Brigade. Can't find anybody, flips it. 3 seconds, he got a shot off. Going in, the tough two is no good. Second chance shot would have gone in had the clock never hit 0.0. Well, I'm not feeling like we're out of the woods yet, not only because we're losing, but also because it's only a 2-point ball game. 40-38. Right here in WHBW, as the players
ladies
are ready to hit the locker room. The Baltimore
Hawks men's basketball team is dedicating today's game to the life and legacy of Morgan Rogers, a former Duke University women's lacrosse student athlete who died tragically in July of 2019 after battling mental health struggles. Although Morgan's life was cut way too short, her legacy of unconditional love remains. Morgan's message was created by her family and former teammates with the mission to eliminate the stigma surrounding mental health, normalize the conversations about mental health, and ensure that mental health is treated equally to physical health for all student athletes. For more information on Morgan's life and legacy and how you can help those with mental health struggles, please visit morgansmessage.org or the Morgan's Message table in the lobby. Thank you.
That's very important. I'm pretty sure we all hopefully know that by now. 40-38. It's halftime, ladies and gentlemen. As we see everything right there. Hopefully that first half is bad. We don't have to have a second thing right. Now we do. Thank you, Noah. We've utilized 10 guys out there. Miles with 9 points. Titus and Braden each have 6. Braden living and dying at the free throw line. The 3-point line, excuse me. Braden 2 for 5 for 3. Jared also has 6 points. I could possibly forget Jared Logan. We're shooting 6 for 15 from the line. But from 3-point land. Tom Morgan shooting 3 for 9. We're shooting better than them, but they have more field goals. 19 points off the bench for the Brown and Gold Brigade. That is half the total for us. Carter Reese with 2 threes today. Will Miller with another 3. Will Miller got fouled well on that 3. Kaden Jacoby leads everybody here with 11 total points. Not so far behind him is Will Miller. What's behind? Not so far behind Will Miller is Carter Reed and Scotty Cunningham Jr. with the 6 each. Well, we'll check out what the women's score is in just a minute. Hopefully we will see it soon. Well, student section isn't that shabby now that I mentioned it. You're right there. So I guess it could be much, much worse. Yeah, this won't be easy to win in the second half. Fans are still having a blast to say the least. May not be two teams that are vying for a national championship, but hey, it's all right. Hopefully the second half goes better, but we struggled in the second half. Really, we've been struggling as of late. We've lost 10 out of the last 11, 11 out of the last 13. Oh, you God. Out of the last 13, 13 out of the last 15, 15 out of the last 20. Some of the games have been close, like go off the first try, and Penn State game went to overtime. John Carroll was an instant classic. Audubon was an 8-point loss, Capital 3-point loss. Marietta wasn't that bad. But outside of that, it's kind of been a bit disastrous. Even wins have been hard to come by for us. Two conference wins this season, one to Muskie, 67 or 62, the other one for Wilmington, 68-62. Still waiting for the good guys to break out of the locker room. That won't be for a while, folks. Like to remind you, Friday night, the Friday night is Highland Hornets State on the Thomas Blue Devils. This is the boys basketball. That'll be fun to watch. That'll be on WHPW. And of course, after that, you got Highland Hornets State and Kenyon Madigan's team. That's right, the Harvard's first team. And it's going to be a big game against Harvard's Madigan. Harvard's has wrapped up the American Conference. They are going to win the conference after not winning a single game. Good Lord. Talk about a turnaround for the Magic. They went from the Tragics back to the Magics, I guess. Coach Astaro does his thing with the Indians and defeats us not once but twice. Told Coach a famous quote that wouldn't be very nice to say on the air. So halfway through the halftime break. Yeah, that was about 63-60 over the Indians. Capital Indians beat us actually. And yeah, we'll be talking about that no foul against Zach Wilson, but honestly, we should never have had that opportunity. Considering the fact that there never has been 4.2 seconds elapsed. 4.2 seconds off, there should have been 0.0, the clock wasn't operating. We almost got super lucky, but in the end, Chop was going to pull away with the win. We're 10-8 on the season. Of course, we lost last night to Medina girls basketball. Not shabby at all. We got Euclid next Saturday, but I think that's also a women's lacrosse game, so I don't think I'll be able to do it. But I'll be at the Finney Stadium. And anyways, thinking back, the men's team, boys team, I should say, 10-8 on the season. We'll probably be lucky if we win 13 games, if we win 3 out of round 4. The other teams are not going to be easy, but 13 not going to be easy. And after what started off pretty promising, a 3-game winning streak at one point, but resulted in at least a 10-8 record for the Black and Green Brigade, and hopefully we can go 14-8, make some noise in the tournament, but I don't know what we're gonna be, who we're gonna be dealing with in the tournament. We don't know yet, folks. Hopefully it'll be an easy path, but I won't sure. Less than 5 minutes to go until it's go time. Bouncing up and down, having fun. I tell ya. Hopefully we have fun by the time the clock hits 0.0. Because that would be sweet to pick up a win. Both teams exit out of their respective blockers simultaneously. We'll be scoring to the right, they'll be scoring to the left. What happens out here? We have 198 days, I repeat, 198 days to go till it's time to play some Highland High School football. We'll be taking on the Hudson Explorers week one once again, but this time at Hudson. Of course, our schedule is the same as it was last year. Can't believe the season's almost here. I'd like to remind you the Hornet Track Invitational coming on March 29th. It's Good Friday. I got to go. Stay from church. Off to Highland High School. I don't know what church I'm going to on Good Friday, but I can't assume the one thing. The Hornet track is taking a blast. It's going to be a whole lot of fun. Hopefully we can get something cooking out here. Two 16 left. Yeah, March 29th. We've got about a little more than a month and a half. Got 51 days to go till the Highland Track Invitational. That's gonna be fun to watch. Of course, Mr. Olympic Stop is the one that and the rest of the game just do a fine job with the track team. As does everybody else. Well, he's one of my favorite events to cover. Hopes. It feels like spring already. Feels like it's spring already. Didn't even bring that winter jacket. So you can stop there and watch the second hardball to start off the second half. 40 to 38. I apologize for that. That, of course, it was not our ball to start off the second half. Down, 20 to go. Good guy ball to start off the second half. And we are just about ready to rock and roll. Inbounding it from the near side. It's Titus Baskerville the floor. Titus finds Luke Driscoll and we're right for the second inning. Luke goes past midcourt. Luke gonna pass that to Andrew. Andrew in trouble. Back out to Luke. Luke gonna go in. Luke gonna pass that to Rob. Hasn't attempted three yet this season as the pass goes out to Titus. Titus spin move. Titus gonna try to step back, passing it to Rob. Rob driving in. Rob spinning. Rob spinning again. He's gonna be fouled, I believe. Yes, he's gonna be fouled. Or stripped out. Regardless, our ball. Not a foul, actually. 8 to shoot. Luke needs to find someone. Luke can't find anybody. He's going to take a timeout. That's a timeout you do not want to burn. 23 seconds through the second half. It'll be a full timeout for Coach Howland Co. And now we've already used half our timeouts out here. That's good to hear.
Congratulations, Christian.
Christian, a good man. He's a good pole vaulter, that's for sure. As it is 40 to 38. I'd like to remind you that Saturday, the good guys will be taking on Wilmington in women's basketball. Next Wednesday, we'll be taking on Heidelberg in the last men's basketball game of the season. That'll be senior night. And then next Saturday is senior night against the Marietta College Pioneers
for the women's team.
Let me assure you, that won't be easy, Marietta. They did beat us here last year. What will happen here? How are you? 23 seconds elapsed in this second half. Now looks like Miles is just gonna give it to Andrew. Now back out to Miles. Five to shoot, passing it to Andrew. Andrew's gotta put up a shot soon. He's gonna drive in, try to tie it. Oh, he's fouled. He's fouled 30 seconds through the second half. Ken Jacoby commits his second foul of the evening. Andrew goes to the line. Andrew 10 for 14 from the line this season. Andrew 11 for 15 from the line this season. Andrew ties in that field. Here comes ONU with an opportunity to reclaim the lead. Unfortunately, we've scored our last 4 points on free throws. Mike allowed to 15 Reese. Now on the right side out to Carter Reese. He holds on to the ball. He's going to spin. Tough two. He got it off the left-handed hook. Carter Reese scored it. Miles gets it in from Titus. Miles going left. Miles driving in. Miles going to have that shot down by the Polar Bears, but fortunately, stole our ball. 59 seconds left, or through the second half. If there were 59 seconds left, I'd be super nervous right now because we're down by two. Rob with it. Rob, oh, no foul. It's Titus going to go out to Miles for three, and it is no good. Here they go the other way. Carter Reese. No, that's Jody Cunningham. There's Carter Reese. Reese to his right. Going to pass that underneath the bucket. Tough two coming up is good. No foul on Rob. Slow to get up there is Cunningham. He scored it. Miles escapes, Miles going in, Miles with a tough shot is rejected. And here they go the other way for two, it's good. We're down by half a dozen, here we go again, folks. Titus running left. Titus loses the ball, Jacoby's gonna take it for him. Here we go again, passing that. There's going to be a blocking foul on Andrew. His third of the day, a minute 56 through this second half as we are going to see a whole conga line in for the good guys. Our entire starting five going to check out. Landon, Caden, Leon, Jared, and Braden going to check in. That's got to be rough for Dave to announce everybody. And now we're down eight. Ooh, down went Jared, but he'll get back up. Spinning up. Caden goes to the right side. Caden passes that to Jared, and now looking Jared Logan left wide alone. Does he dare take a three? Yes, he does, and he got it. 48-43. We're now down five, but everything's going in for Ohio Northern in the second half so far. But thank God we've only played 2.5 minutes of it. Reese passes out to Jacoby. Jacoby to the right side where Will Miller awaits. Will Miller out to Cunningham. Jody Cunningham going to pass that to the right side. Here they go. Passing it back out to 15 Reese. What do they do here? Lobbing that one left side. Easy two for Caden Jacoby, the freshman from Pettisville. 43-50 as Braden has it. All our backups are in right now. Our backups win more than our starters. Our bench, I should say. Landon going in. Landon with a nice move. He's fouled and the bucket. All right, that's more like it. 3 minutes, 8 seconds for the second half. Johnny Cunningham Jr. just committed his third foul of the ball game. Landon going to the line. Landon got it. 4-point game. We're really getting it done at the free throw line today. We are, what now? 7-for-9, I think. Reese. Carter Reese. Reese passes that to Cunningham, and now here's Will Miller. Miller going to give that one off to Jacoby, the easy 2-pointer off the glass. Here is number 2, Landon Potopski, stepping back. Landon looking. Landon passes that to Jared. Jared going to give it off back to Landon. Landon spinning. Landon looking. Landon passes that to Rob. Nice pump fake by Rob. Rob going in. Rob going to flip it back out to Braden. Braden has it stripped from him. Here come the Bears again. Out to number 4, Blake Mitchell. Michael, actually. Not Mitchell. Michael. And trying to get that out on the Bears, he does. Good move there by Landon. As number 1, Mason Studer will be checking in. 4 minutes, 1 second through the second half.
Number 1, Mason Studer, number 3, Noah Langdon.
Good play by the good guys as Caden Madigan has it, the former Wadsworth Grizzly. Caden going left, passing that to Jared. Jared eyeing Braden, and Braden almost forgot it, but he recovers. Passing it to Landon. Landon going to step back. Landon going to go in. Landon pass out to Braden. Good three shooter, and he misses. Passing that underneath the bucket. The 2-pointer is nice and easy for Blake Mark. 54-46, Landon going in, Landon passes out, Landon is fouled. 4 minutes and 38 seconds through the second half. I don't know where the pep band goes to get their pizza and stuff, but I mean, I know they go to Antonio's, but we're at BW. Right side, good snag there by Caden who's going in. Caden passed that back out. Jared for three, it is good. We're now down by 5, as you can tell. Studer on the right side, passing it around. Number 15 is Carter Reese. Reese to the right side where Jacoby looking. Jacoby goes in, Jacoby flips it out, and now Carter Reese wide alone, and Carter misses. Our ball, thanks to the rebound there by Jared. 5-point contest. Landon steps back out to Jared. Jared having a hot hand as of late, passing it to Leon. Leon for three, no foul. Now a foul called. And Leon will go to the line with an opportunity to make this a little more interesting. But Leon's been struggling at the free throw line this season. 3-for-9 at the charity stripe this season. Well, he's now 4-for-10.
Time out, Polar Bears.
Owen Hugh takes a 30-second TO. Still in the first part of the second half, first half of the second half. Keep in mind, there are no quarters in men's basketball. There is in women's. Couldn't tell you what the score was of the women's game if my life depended on it. I did not bring my computer. It's awfully low on battery. Five minutes, 24 seconds through this second half. Leon will go back to the line in a 4-point contest. He can make at least 3 or 2. same five in for us as it was a little while ago. Second shot good. We're just doing a dandy so far at the line, aren't we? No way I can make it a two-point game. He does just that. He's now shooting 50% at the line. We're shooting 10 for 12 at the line tonight. That might be the difference maker for us. Langford going right, passing it to the right side. That's Mann. And a nice easy two-point. Well, no. Here we go with the ball. Kaden passes that to Jared. Jared gonna give that one off right, the left side, Landon. Landon was going right. That's what tripped me up, as here's Jared going in. Jared is blocked. My goodness, what a save. Braden tries to get, Braden can't get it. Here they go, passing it back wide along. Was Connolly's gonna pass it back again on the right side. Gonna try to drive in, passing it. There's a travel call by the side. Ooh, the three would have gone in two, so we'll take that every day of the week. 6 minutes, 7 seconds elapsed in the second half. Kaden on the right side. Kaden going left. Kaden Madigan. With the good guys down four. Landon Potocki going in. Landon for two. It is gone. 56-54. Number five is Connolly. Connolly passes that to number three, Langford. Langford's intercepted by Jared. We'll see what Jared does. Two-handed slam of this ball game is tied. 56-56. And Ohio Northern in deep danger of letting the momentum slip away from their fingers. Here's a three coming up, but that might snuff it out. Will Miller for three. Three-point contest once again. Good spin move there by Kaden. Kaden out to Jared. Jared gonna hand it off to Landon. Landon looking, he's got Jared wide alone. Why not? No, he doesn't take a three. Now he takes a three. He is good! Jared's having a great game out here today. 59-59. Great second half for sure as well. Cottley passes that to Langford. Langford right side. Gonna try to go in. Spin move. Passes it back out. 3 point for Studer. Studer. Oh, that's a foul on Theo Mag, if I ever saw so. 7 minutes. And 34 seconds for this second half. Titus checking in for Kaden. And Ohio Northern really making a lot of mistakes out there with the fouling. 5 fouls so far, and we're not even halfway through the half. Johnny Cunningham Jr. and Kaden Jacoby check in for the Bears. Now we can do something we haven't done in a while, take the lead. Driving in out in the corner, Braden for three. Boom! Shakalaka! And now they're gonna take the timeout! So you're telling me we might win this game? 62-59. And once again, the Polar Bears in deep trouble of letting this game slip away from their fingers. It's going down to three timeouts out here. It'll be a full timeout, judging by the fact that everybody is sitting down right now. Coach Howell's got to be happy with this second half showing. We've outscored 24-19 in the second half. Jared Logan just putting up a clinic out there. But Braden Hamilton also doing a great job as well. Braden Hamilton good at what he does. 12:13 to go in the second half. You see the score at the top right corner of your screen. What will happen here as we are running to Ray Cuddle? Twelve 13.
songs that I keep on mentioning. What will happen in this second half? Ohio Northern ball, Braden having a good day. Jared, of course, having a great day. Mainly our bench players having a fine day today. I think all our points this half have come via the bench. We'll see what happens in this time of the ball game. Number 21 is Jody Cunningham Jr. Cunningham passes that to Kristen Connolly, now on the left side. That's number 15 being Carter Reese. Jacoby right side, now looking right here. That's number 15 Reese. On the left side, Jacoby. Jacoby, oh, it's rejected, but a foul call. We're on commit to second foul. Andrew checking in for us. Caden Jacoby, who is shooting under 50% at the free throw line this season, is going to make the first 2-point contest. Andrew in for Leon, probably due to the foul trouble. Second shot. Missed, they got it back, passing it back, driving in, the two quarters tough, and we're tied at 62. The Polar Bears have really been getting away with a subpar performance at the free throw line tonight. Is this ball gonna get away from us? Gonna pass it a little too far, intended for number 21, Jody Cunningham Jr. Our ball, 11:36 in the second half. There's Jared. Jared looking. Jared driving in. Jared for, nope, he's fouled. 11:24 left, and you see Coach Neil Young, he's not happy at all with his
foul
player.
Jacoby, his third.
Jacoby commits a foul.
To the line, shooting two. Number 24.
Jared returning to the free throw line out there. Oh, Jared missed. Fair miss for him. He's now 20 for 28, fair minimum in this season when it comes to free throw shooting. One more foul, of course, will be in the bonus as we reclaim the lead. 63-62, what's been a high scoring spit swabbing showdown. The Cavs are tied with the Wizards at 57 right now. Number five is Connolly. Connolly out to the left side. Going to pass that out to Connolly. No, that's number two, Will Miller. Will Miller spinning. Will Miller turnaround. Tough two, no good. And we are going to get that back. Titus passes that to Jared. Why not Jared Logan? Passing that. Titus Baskerville, the fourth. No, Miles Reynolds. Excuse me. 65-62, my apologies once again. Right side, here comes the three on the way. It's around the rim and not in. Rebounded by Jared, and we can really get some breathing room out here if we can score. It is out on ONU with 10:36 to go in the second half. Blake Michael in for them, Luke Crisco in for us. Miles Reynolds once again scored that last two-pointer right there. Not Titus. Braden finds Titus, speaking of which. Titus out to Andrew. Andrew right side, good pump fake. Miles with a tough two. It's good! Miles Reynolds not fouled, but you know what? He got the two-pointer nonetheless. And oh, he's not fouled again, as here they go, driving in. The tough two is good. No foul called once again. Jody Cunningham Jr.'s, we are off to the races, but that's going to backfire as it's picked off. Right side, going to heave that one out. The two-pointer, no good by number four, Blake Michael. Michael again, no good. Halfway through the second half, try to pick up what would be our third conference win of the season. Miles has it. Miles to the right side where Braden awaits. Giving it off to Miles. Miles almost lost something. Miles going in. He's going to try a shot. He is not fouled. Coach Howell can't believe it. Right side they go. Driving in, spinning, stopping, passing it back. That's Connolly. Connolly out to 15. Carter Reese. Reese steps back, going underneath the bucket. The easy two-pointer is blown. Oh, my. I don't believe it. Titus on the left side. Titus looking. Titus driving in. Titus passes that. Out of bounds on us. 9 minutes, 11 seconds. Braden gonna sit on down. He's had himself a fine one so far. Landed in for us. No sign of Jared Logan. As Rob Watson, the third, will be checking in for Titus.
Also in the game for your real attendance, number 32, Rob.
Here comes Ohio Northern, a three ties it. Be thinking three here, a three-pointer from Carter Reese is good. 67-67. Luke Driscoll inbounding it to number one, Miles Reynolds, and now Luke Driscoll. Driscoll looking. Driscoll to his left. Luke is spinning, he's trying to find someone. He finds Miles, and now that's Andrew out to Rob. Rob with a nice move. He got it. 69-67. Rob Watson, the third, scores it. 8.5. Looking. Number four. That's Blake Michael. He's got an easy path to the bucket. We're tied at 69. 8:20 to go here in the second. Luke trying to cross up. Luke trying to show up his defender. Looking towards the left side. Surprised he didn't call travel on that. Miles looking. Miles going in. Miles not going to be fouled. He got it back. He puts it up. He puts it in. Miles makes it 71-69. Going to try to cross up. Going to try going the tough two and the foul. Looked like Miles did the fouling. The good news, Jared's going to be at back in. It was Miles that committed the foul. You see Jared right there.
Miles Reynolds is first team third.
Jared gets checking for him. He's checking in for Andrew. And this game is tied at 71.
Into the game for your Yellow Jackets, number 21, Jared Logan. To the line for the 81, number 21, Johnny Cunningham.
Haven't seen Nick Timberlake at all yet as the three-point play is good. That's certainly odd. Nick Timberlake usually plays a lot. Bears lead 7:48 in the second half. Luke gonna go to his left, passing that one almost in out of the hands of Miles. Miles passes that to Rob. Rob out right side. Good save there. Gonna go in as Luke. Look for two, we got it, we are winning again, 73-72. Gonna pass that on the right side, and now underneath the bucket, spinning, two-point foul again, bucket again. That looked to be number 34, Caden Jacoby. Rob commits the foul. He's got three fouls.
Logan is good to the line. Number shooting in one, number 34, Caden Jacoby.
I don't think Rob has a single point. Neither does Andrew. No, never mind. Andrew does have some points. Rob does not. 74-73 is now 75-73 on WHPW. It's the penultimate game here at the Erskine Gymnasium for the Yellow Jackets men's team this year. Jared's got it. Jared looking right side. Luke not taking the three. Luke gonna pass that back out to Jared. Jared driving in. Jared for two. We are tied 75 apiece.
Jared Logan.
This game may be coming down to these next 6:50 out here. Studer with it, passing it on the left side. That is number 34 being Jacoby. Driving in, looking, the tough two is fouled again. Jared commits a foul. He just nods his head thinking, how was that a foul? So 6:40 left, and we summon Ohio Northern to the free throw line once again.
To the line, shooting two, number 15. Carter Reese
going to the line. Reese makes the first. 76-75, high scoring ball game, isn't it, folks? Here comes the second shot. It is no good. Jared on the rebound. Luke has it. Luke on the right side. Luke stepping back. Luke lobs it out to Landon. Back out to Rob. Rob out to Luke. Luke not taking the three. He's going to take a two instead. He got to go. 77-76 out here in Berea. Number one is Studer. Studer passes that to Reese. Reese going in. Reese going back. Carter Reese gives it off. Now here they go, number four, Blake Michael. Michael looking. Michael out to Langford. No Langford, an offensive foul is going to be called on ONU. Braden checking back in for us. We're in the bonus.
Offensive foul.
Jacoby has committed four fouls today.
Into the game.
He is in deep foul trouble.
Bears, number two, Will Miller, and number 21, Johnny Cunningham, Jr.
Under 6 minutes to go here in the second half. Luke has it. Luke going to try to step back. Luke going to go left. Luke hands it off to Braden. Braden to his left. Braden trying to make something happen out here. He hands it off to Miles. Miles going in. Miles passes a shot down by ONU, but Jared got it back and he is fouled. 5:36 to go till we hit the end of regulation. Jared Logan returns to the free throw line. Blake Michael now in foul trouble though. He's got four. It has been the silly fouls that's been killing Ohio Northern tonight as Jared easily makes the first. Nothing new for the junior from Illyria County.
Number five, Carson Connolly.
It's Carson Connolly back in for ONU. Three-point ball game. Number 21 is Jody Cunningham Jr. Cunningham going right. Jody driving in and a reach in front. No bucket will be awarded. It ain't going anyways. 5 minutes.
Number five, Luke Driscoll is first.
Carter Reese back in for the Bears.
Number 15, Carter Reese.
Looks like Reese is inbounding. Reese looking right side. Gonna step back out here. High lob and oh, too high. Gonna be our ball. 5:19 left. I'm honestly surprised that Neil Young is not taking a timeout yet. There is Jared on the left side. Jared going in. Jared looking, Jared passes out. Oh, Landon is gonna be fouled with 5 minutes, 6 seconds to go.
Foul on number 15, Carter Reese. He's third.
Reese has committed three fouls now. One more will be in the bonus pause.
Into the game for the Bull Bears, number 33.
Landon to the line. He's 2 for 2 from the line today.
To the line, shooting two. Number two,
3-point contest. We are on top against ONU. There's your first shot. 80-76.
Number 33.
Theo Mag is in for ONU. Second shot coming up for Landon. He's a little short. Jared tries to race for it. Wow, how about that? Miles out to Braden. Braden's going to take a three. He missed. Oh, that's rough. We're up by four. We give it to Carson Conway, who gives it off to number two, Will Miller. 21 is Cunningham. Cunningham running right. Jody Cunningham steps back, passes it to number two, Will Miller. Will Miller stops, pops, shoots, makes it. And thus it is 80-78. 4:33 left, the John Cage time left. Now less than that by now. Jared not fouled. Gonna pass that to Landon. Landon left side. Landon gonna drive in. Landon passing that out to Luke. Luke with 4:16. Luke gonna try to go in. Luke gonna still try going. Take the two-pointer. He got it. 42-78. Honestly, still surprised the Bears haven't burned a timeout yet. Time is running out. There's less than 4 minutes in regulation. Cunningham passing it in. The spin move, the two-pointer. It is good by Theo Mann. Thus, 82-80. 3:41 left in regulation. Luke steps back. Luke gives off to Braden. Braden out. Luke spinning. Luke passes that. Braden, and no, the three-pointer coming up is no good. I look to be landing on the three-pointer. I apologize. Gonna go in here. The two-pointer. We're tied at 82. Maybe that's why they didn't take a timeout. Carter Reese scored it. Speaking of timeouts, a timeout burned. 3 minutes, 9 seconds left in the second half. Tommy Maroon here. Having ourselves a good one, aren't we? We have outscored them 44-42 in the second half. Jared Logan doing well, Brent Hamilton doing well, Miles Brown doing well. Everybody having a good job out here tonight. 82 apiece with 3 minutes, 9 seconds to go. Coach Tom's got to be a little nervous about this. So the fight's all gonna be played out here. We're up 82-78, but they have rallied the tie out here. Still talking things over. Two timeouts left for the Yellow Jackets. Three timeouts left for Neil Young's Ohio Northern Polar Bear. Three minutes, 9 seconds. Tie ball game here in Berea. Our ball on the far side. Good game by two good schools out here. Ohio Northern trying to stay afloat in the OAC tournament race. We're just trying to get a moral victory out here. They never hurt folks. Luke going right, Luke going left, Luke in trouble. Luke just spinning his wheels 3 minutes in the second half. Luke Driscoll passing, no, he's gonna shoot it, and now Landon try to get, that's out of Ohio Northern, isn't it? 12 to shoot, 2:55 left in regulation. Caden Jacoby in for them. Jacoby's gotta be careful, cause one foul by him and he's out of here, at least I think. On the left side, it's Jared. Jared with a high, deep pass. That's Luke on the catch. Luke passes that left side. And now Landon Potocki for three. He missed. Rebound by Will Miller. 2:40 left. Number five is Carson Cattaway now. Number two, Will Miller. Miller on the left side. Passing it on the left side again. Spinning, looking. The tough two-pointer, no good. Tipped, good. Rebound by Braden. Braden's going to flip it back out. 220 left. It's coming down this, folks. Look to the left side where Jared has it. Jared going to give it off to Landon. Landon with the tough two. He got it! 208 left. Still not taking a timeout yet. Johnny Cunningham Jr. with less than two to go. Cunningham lobbing that one. No travel, instead a foul. And Caden Jacoby with an opportunity to make it a one, maybe two-point ball game, or one-point ball game, maybe a tie ball game.
Shoot the 1-1, number 34, Caden Jacoby.
Depending on what happens here on his first shot. To Caden Jacoby that made both his free throws last time. He got the first one. 84-83, 114 seconds left in the second half. Neil Young still not taking a timeout. He's got three in his pocket. No good, falling down and travel call. Minute 52. And now the Bears are going to burn a timeout. Well, if you're just tuning in, you couldn't have picked a better time to tune in. It's a one-point ball game. 84-83 our score. Each school in the bonus, if there's a jump ball, that will be their ball. Judging by the scorer's table right there, you see the possession arrow in favor of Ohio Northern. You see both teams are in the bonus. One more foul by ONU, we will reach the double bonus. Seven fouls for the good guys. A lot of foul trouble for Ohio Northern. Two timeouts left for each school. As Coach Young's got to be nervous, as is Coach Tom. He's talking things over with the game. What will happen here is a question. That's a question we may not know for a while. Before. 1:52, Ohio North ready to go. seconds left in this second half. 84-83 reads the score. Brown and Gold Brigade on top. Can the oldest and greatest university in America hold on? Right side, Reese. Oh, Eagle screen! That's going to be... No, he went out of bounds! He went out of bounds! 110 seconds left. Can we put him to bed out here? It's a little too early to put him to bed, but you never know. Looking. Driving in Jared for two. Jared misses. Jared fouled. Number two is Will Miller.
Will Miller is second team 10.
Miller did the fouling right there with 96 seconds to go in the second half. Jared going to the line. 84-83. Oh, he airballed that thing. That's rough. This game is more high scoring than what do you call it. And the game against John Carroll in regulation, because that was 83-83. It's right now 84-83, as you can tell on your screen. Jared going to try it again. Hopefully this goes a little bit better. It does go a little bit better. In fact, it goes a lot better. Here they go. Two ties at three gives them the lead. Driving in, the two-pointer is no good. Tipped, rebounded, looking. Tough two is good by Caden Jacoby with 76 seconds left. There are about 46 seconds in between the shot clock and game clock, and Luke Driscoll burns a timeout with 69 seconds left in the second half. What a game. Guy, I'll tell you about that. I can only assume that Coach Sean's got to be even more nervous. This has been a good one, 85 apiece. There are 46 seconds in the shot clock and game clock. I can only hope for winning in women's basketball. Got some friends down at Polar Bears. Of course, I'll ask them what's going on in that game. 85-85 on WHPW. We have one timeout to burn. Once again, if there's a jump ball, it'd be Polar Bear ball. Both teams in the bonus. We are in the bonus plus. Here you'll get a good view of everything. 69 seconds left. Jared's going to inbound to Luke. He does not go behind midcourt. We'll have about a minute to go. Braden has it. He's a sharp shooter. Watch out for Braden. 1 minute in the second half. Miles going left. Miles out to Braden. You left him wide open. That's a big mistake. It's good. It's good. Braden Hamilton made it. But here come the Bears the other way. Timeout with 53.1 seconds to go. Braden made the biggest shot of the night for us. He's right there. Holy cow! ...88-85, Braden Hamilton coming up huge again. And there are about 24 seconds separate the shot clock and game clock out here as they're trying to get something cooking out here. What will happen next? I do not know. All I do know is that this has been too good of a game, maybe too good to be true. 88-85, WHBW's got you covered not tomorrow, Friday night when we take on the Talmadge Blue Devils in boys basketball, and then Saturday will be the game against the Lakers. All right, ready to break puddle out here. Cut band having fun. I don't know if you can tell. And everybody going nuts. I don't know. Do you go with a three right now? I don't know. So all too early, they're going to go past midcourt out here with 21. Johnny Cunningham Jr. passing it to Blake Michael. Our sideline, Channing defenses. Here we go. Ken Jacoby right side. 21, that's Cunningham. Cunningham being guarded by Braden, passing down the right side. There's 12 to shoot. Cunningham, fouled by Braden. 34.6 to go in regulation.
Number four, Braden Hamilton, his second, team eighth. To the line, shooting the one and one. Number 21, Johnny Cunningham Jr.
Johnny Cunningham Jr., does he dare intentionally miss as Titus will go check back in a minute. He misses the front end of the one and one.
A field goal on it, there's the trick. Foul called, sending landed to the line. 28.8 to go. And now everybody aware of what could happen. Now Cunningham skating on thin ice. We need to be quiet. We need Landon to make at least one. That would be nice. See that 8 people are tuning in right now. You couldn't pick a better time to tune in. Oh, he missed. He missed. Mason Studer and Will Miller back in for the Bears. 88-85 our score. If Ohio Northern gets it, they can hold it for the last shot. 88-85. That is if Landon misses. Oh, he missed again. I'd probably take a timeout here. Driving in the tough two, no foul, no bucket, rebounded. That's going to be a jump ball with 14.8 left. Still going to be ONU ball as a timeout is burned by Ohio Northern. 14.8, it's coming down this. ONU out of timeouts. Neil Young's got to be sweating like anything. This is the same school he defeated 86-64 earlier this season. Because somehow this will have nothing but a win considering the course this season has gone this year. He'll have a win. And this Earthspun Gymnasium has not that bad tonight, really making a lot of noise right now. But now has one timeout to burn. If they got a three, if they miss the bucket, they're getting first win over and we're going to walk away winners. Well, our wins in the conference haven't been easy. We beat Muskie 67-62. And we beat Wilmington 68-62. The catch was that we had Ray Ellington and Adrian Costello. Ellington and Agent Costello are not in for us tonight. There are two leading scorers, Ray averaging 19.7, AJ averaging 13.8. You couldn't tell if they were in or whatnot. We're doing that good to replace them, and that is not an easy task to do. Reese inbounding. High lob all the way back. Left side, Carter Reese, that is off, that is no good. And we're going to get the rebound! Foul call, 9 seconds left. Reese missed it.
Foul on number 34, King Jacoby, his fifth.
Jacoby has fouled out.
To the line, shooting the
number. Obviously, you gotta send the whole gang back. Miles gonna go to the line. Miles just having a dandy at the free throw line this season.
Into the game for the
number 33, number that is mad. No, number 20, Hayden Hansen, actually. Hayden Hansen, 6'9", he's a sophomore. That ought to do it. That ought to do it. 89-85 our score. Braden with the play of the game. Braden and Jared both win players of the game tonight. That really ought to do it. They got a hurry. They got a desperation shot. Here it comes on the way. Game over. Jackets win. Jackets win 90-85. Oh my goodness. For the third time this season in the OAC, we have won a game in men's basketball. Coach Dobhoff's got to feel really relieved
The six-game winning streak is over. And the Brown and Gold Brigade walk away winners. What a game. I'll be honest, I didn't think we were going to win it tonight. But what did we do? How about that? A mini upset right here. Is everybody enjoying this one? Everybody's enjoying the heck out of this one. 90-85 the final. In the locker room. That's going to be all the time we have left here at WHBW. We own the sixth greatest university in America. Why, God's in the second half. We got 52 in the second half. Ohio Northern was only able to put up 25. And now we're done for the night. Thank you for watching. Until next time, I'm Tommy Maroon. Wish you a good night. And so long from Maria. With the good guys winning 90-85.